Juan Gilberto Gomez. Juan Gilberto Gomez was born free of enslavement on the sugar plantation to parents Furman Gomez and Serafina Ferrer in Manzanares, Cuba on July 12, 1854. His parents were able to purchase his freedom before his birth, which allowed him to be able to learn to read and write. Because of the existence of slavery, most people of African descent were not able to read and write. Gomez's parents used the money they had to enroll him in school at Our Lady of the Forsaken in Havana, Cuba, to further his education. 1968 was the beginning of the 10 Years War, which was an uprising by Cuban planters and indigenous Cubans within the Cuban fight for independence against Spain. Because the Cubans were fighting for their independence from Spain, the racial tensions were high, which led to a brawl between Spanish and Cuban groups at a theater. Gomez was a part of the brawl, and because of his participation, he was targeted by the Spanish. His parents sent him to Paris, France, with the help of their former plantation owner, Catalina Gomez. Juan Gomez was going to Paris to learn how to become a carriage maker, a profession that was seen to be most suitable for a Cuban of African descent. While in Paris learning to become a carriage maker, Gomez's teacher noticed his high level of intelligence and convinced Gomez's parents to spend their money on him learning a formal education in engineering. In 1872, Gomez earned a job as a translator for Cuban independence leaders Francisco Vicente Aguilera and General Manuel de Quesada, who was looking for funding for the fight for Cuban independence. War and political strife broke out in France while Gomez was matriculating through his schooling, and because of the political climate, Gomez, along with other Parisians, began experiencing economic hardships. 2 years later, Gomez's parents informed him that they could no longer support his education because of their own economic downturn. Gomez decided to be resilient and self-sufficient. He began working full-time at the Journal and Theater Gazette newspaper. Gomez working at the newspaper allowed him to merge his activism with his newfound love for journalism. He was able to create a persona as a journalist who was a political activist, public speaker, and an important member of the Cuban fight for independence. In 1878, Gomez moved back to Cuba after a trip to Mexico to meet with Cuban abolitionist Nicolas Azacarte, where he learned about the Cubans being defeated during the 10 Years War. So he moved back to help rejuvenate the Cuban fight for independence. After returning to Cuba, Gomez bonded with a fellow Cuban in the fight for independence named Jose Marti. Gomez and Marti began planning for an uprising known as the Little War, an uprising that began in 1879. Also in 1879, Gomez started a newspaper called The Brotherhood. During these early phases of Gomez operating The Brotherhood, he was exiled to Spain for 10 years because of his role in the Little War. During his 10 years in Spain, Gomez was able to write for several newspapers, continuing to sharpen his journalism skills and continuing his part in the Cuban fight for independence. In 1890, Gomez was able to return to Cuba, where he and Marti picked up where they left off 10 years ago. They began planning an uprising that went unnoticed by Spanish authorities, which led to a surprise attack on Spanish forces in February of 1895. The rebellion was not successful. It is believed this rebellion and many other early rebellions were unsuccessful because of the lack of support from the people of Cuba. On February 28, 1895, Gomez was captured by the Spanish and sentenced to 20 years in prison, but he only actually served 3 years. After his release, Gomez moved to New York City and continued his fight for Cuban independence. Gomez, along with Cuba's Major General Plácido García, traveled to Washington, D.C. in 1898 to negotiate with the American government for funds to help the Cuban Liberation Army. Between 1906 and 1909, Gomez was able to be a part of the committee that amended the Cuban Constitution and became a prominent voice speaking for Afro-Cubans on a national level against the racism Afro-Cubans were facing. Gomez and his fellow Cuban freedom fighters were not only fighting the physical domination by the Spanish, but they were also fighting the racial segregation the Spanish used against the Afro-Cubans. The idea was that Afro-Cubans were a threat to the whiteness or the Europeanness of the Spanish. Gomez became known as a dedicated freedom fighter for Afro-Cuban people, He defended Afro-Cubans from various backgrounds and professions and became the most recognizable face of the Afro-Cuban fight for independence. As memories of their fight for independence passed, Gomez and other Afro-Cuban leaders were beginning to be forgotten. Racial discrimination was increasing and impacting Afro-Cubans' quality of life. In retaliation to the continued discrimination and political blackballing, the Afro-Cubans created their own political party called the Independent Colored Party, a party that was created without Gomez. Ironically, he opposed the party because he wanted a Cuba free of racial separation, but this party was created to deal with the current reality the Cubans were facing. In 1901, Gomez became a writer that used his writings to speak out against the U.S. interactions in Cuba, looking to make Cuba a U.S. colony. Gomez died in 1933 at the age of 78 as an honored Cuban journalist and freedom fighter. An annual journalism prize was named in honor of Gomez because of the legacy he built for his continued fight for Afro-Cuban independence. Juan Gualberto Gomez, we proudly stand on your shoulders. For more information about On the Shoulders of Giants, a plethora of African heroes, and the On the Shoulders of Giants book series, please visit www.ontheshoulders1.com. And you can support On the Shoulders of Giants on Patreon at patreon.com/OTSOG.